हेलो हेलो एवरीवन, दिस साइड पूनम ग्रोवर फ्रॉम सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, फारुक नगर, गुरुग्राम। टुडे आई स्टार्ट विद माय टॉपिक दैट इज बेस्ड अपॉन योर डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन विच आर बेनिफिट फॉर ETC 6 सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट। एंड वी आर स्टार्ट विद लेक्चर 17 विच आर केम अंडर यूनिट 3 in which we can cover the topic that is ASK, FSK, PSK and BPSK. These four are called digital modulation technique, in which first one is called your amplitude shift keying, and the second one is called your frequency shift keying, and the third one is called your phase shift keying, and the last one is called your binary phase shift keying. Both are the same thing. So before start the video with your digital communication, I told about what is your analog communication and what is your digital communication. In analog communication, your information signal is before modulation, that is continuous, but in digital communication, your information signal in the form of digital are like 0 or 1. So the various advantage of digital communication or analog communication that is covered by with the help of that modulation technique. So digital modulation technique having various advantage, like information capacity is more as compared to your analog communication, and high data security, quicker system availability with great quality of communication. Hence digital modulation technique have a greater demand for their capacity to convey the large amount of analog and large amount of data. So in case of your digital communication, you are having various input, one is called your data input and other one is called your carrier. A carrier is a high frequencies wave which can generate with the help of VCO. VCO stands for your voltage control oscillator. So in that case, we are apply one input signal information and other one is called your that should be clear with the help of one diagram, in which the one signal is called your information and the other is called your carrier, which are not present here. And that last one, you are getting the ASK with the modulated output. So in that case, we can say that your carrier will change its various characteristics as per amplitude, frequency or phase. Your modulation should be done and you are getting the ASK, FSK and PSK at the corresponding output. So we vary only one characteristics at that particular time, according to which you can differentiate among various type of modulation technique which we can use in your digital modulation. One is called your ASK, in which amplitude is vary of the carrier wave in accordance with your digital input. In FSK, in which frequency is vary according to your input. In PSK, in which phase is vary. But in QM, both amplitude and phase is vary. So that's why its name is quadrature amplitude modulation. So the digital modulation technique is very much simpler and it having various advantage over your digital communication. So that advantage we are mentioned here. Digital modulation provides more information capacity and high data security, quicker system and availability with great quality of communication. So here we also mention some basic discussion on your ASK, FSK, PSK and QAM. In ASK, your amplitude of the carrier wave vary in accordance with your information signal, but in your FSK, the frequency of the carrier wave vary in accordance with your input signal. But in PSK, your phase is vary in accordance with your input signal. So these are four are called your digital modulation technique. These are very much beneficial among the, you can say, in case of your communication part. Last one, ASK come with your mathematical expression. Here we see that your digital information signal either in the form of 1 and 0, but carrier is not present here. And the last one you are seeing that is a ASK with modulated output. So if you see here where the input value of wave is 1, the carrier is present, but where the input is 0, the carrier is diminished. So In that case, we can say that your carrier will vary in accordance with your input signal. So the last one output show your ASK modulated output waveform with with carrier. The last one, that is a mathematical expression for your VASK, you can say ASK with modulated waveform, that is equal to 1 plus VMT A by 2 cos of omega C into T. VM is the VM is your information data, and cos of omega C is your carrier with a cos function. And if both are mixed, then you can getting the last expression, that is 1 plus VMT A by 2 cos of omega CT. Any modulated signal has a high frequency as carrier. The binary signal when ASK is modulated gives a zero value for low input and gives the carrier output for high input. So in which VSK is your amplitude shift keying with modulated waveform, and VMT is called your digital information signal, and A by 2 is unmodulated carrier amplitude, omega C is analog carrier frequency in radians per second. So here we show your the Bloch diagram of your ASK transmitter, or you can say ASK modulator, in which we can use one product modulator, and the ASK require one side is modulation signal and the other side is your carrier wave. So your modulation signal is in the form of digital data, and the carrier is, that is a high frequencies wave, and you are getting the ASK with modulated waveform. The input binary sequence is applied to your product modulator. The product modulator amplitude modulates the sinusoidal carrier. It passes the carrier when the input bit is 1, and it blocks the carrier when the input bit is 0. So again, start with your frequency shift keying. The frequency in which the frequency of the carrier vary in accordance with your digital data. The FSK is a scheme of frequency modulation, and you also see here that is a waveform representation of your FSK modulation, in which one is called your input signal, that is in the form of digital, and the carrier is not present here. You show if you require, and last one you're getting the FSK with modulated output. So in that case, where the signal is present, the frequency will be increased, and where the you can getting the zero value of the input signal, the frequency will be expand. It means frequency will be decreased. So in that case, your frequency will be vary as per the nature of your input waveform, either 1 or 0. So the output with the frequency where the signal is 0, the frequency will decrease, that is called your F1, or you can say space frequency, or where the signal is present, the frequency will be increased, and that frequency is called your Mach frequency. So in that case, the FSK is a form of constant amplitude angle modulation similar to standard frequency modulation, except that modulating signal is a binary signal that varies between two discrete voltage level rather than continuously changing analog waveform. Consequently, FSK is sometimes called binary FSK. The general expression for FSK as shown in my next slide, that is VFSK, that is your modulated waveform of the FSK, or you can say resultant, and VC is the VC cos 2 pi FC plus VM del F T. So in which we mention here plus minus del F for the Mach and space frequency. Here we mentioned plus minus del F for the Mach and space frequency. So where the frequency will be increased, your carrier will added with your FM, and where the frequency will be decreased, your carrier is minus from your FS. So in that case, you can say that you can getting the two frequency shift. One is called your plus del F and other is called your minus del F. So that's why its name is Mach frequency to represent logic 1. And that's why we say that is a space frequency to represent logic 0. So according to the Mach and space frequency are separated from the carrier frequency by the peak frequency deviation from each other by 2f. 2f means if you are taking the अपर एंड लोअर फ्रिक्वेंसी डिफरेंस दैट इज इक्वल टू योर 2f. Frequency deviation is illustrated as in the frequency FSK in time domain analysis as show that is your binary input with a continuous sequence of your 1 and 0, and that is called your analog output, or you can say in the form of your FSK modulated wave, where when the signal is 0, the input waveform have expanding in nature, and when the signal is 1, the input waveform have compressive in nature. So in that case, your frequency will be deviated by two phenomena. One is called your minus del f, another is called your plus del f. So the minus del f is called your space frequency, and the plus del f is called your Mach frequency. So as per the truth table, we say that where the zero is present, you can mark it as an space frequency, and where the signal is one, you can mark that frequency as an Mach frequency. So that show your final value of FSK with modulated waveform. What do you mean by bandwidth? Bandwidth is that is a difference of your highest frequency minus my lowest frequency, which we can see here. That is difference of FS minus FC and FS plus FM. So difference of two frequency is called your bandwidth. So after calculating, you can getting the final output, that is F plus may FB. Then we came under your FSK transmitter, and FSK transmitter that is also a part of your input data plus your carrier. The input data is known turn to the value 0, that is called your binary input, and your voltage control oscillator generate a fixed frequency of oscillation that should be applied some, you can say modulator here, or you can say product modulator here. If both are multiplied with each other, then you're getting the final output in the form of plus del f, and you can say in the form of minus del f. As my previous slides, I also show the plus del f is called your Mach frequency and your space frequency. So that phenomena will be reversed to each other in case of your non-return to zero value, or you can say return to zero value. So in return to zero, that phenomena show your minus del f, and here we show plus del f. So that's why it's represent logic zero and logic one. So according to non-return to zero value, that frequency will be changed as an Mach, or you can say as an space. Next, start with your, you can say that consequently the binary input signal changes back and forth between logic 1 and logic 0 condition, and the VCO output shifts or deviates back and forth between Mach and space frequency. Next, we start with your coherent and non-coherent type FSK receiver, or you can say FSK demodulator. So in that case, your coherent and non-coherent are differentiate, or you can say separate with each other. The coherent क्या होता है? Coherent में हम जो carrier लेते हैं, वो जो जैसे suppose करो आपके पास दो चीजें हैं. One is transmitter, another is coherent receiver. In transmitter we can use one carrier, and in receiver we also use a one carrier. In transmitter the carrier help to modulate the signal, but in receiver the carrier is help to demodulate the signal. So both carrier in case of your non coherent FSK receiver are not synchronized with each other in with phase and frequency, but in case of your coherent receiver, your both carrier either in transmitter and receiver are synchronized with each other. So that's why its name is coherent FSK receiver. So here we show the diagram for your non-coherent receiver, and we are giving the input FSK in the form of modulated, and after you can give your power splitter, and the power splitter is help to differentiate between two of this frequency, that is one is called your space frequency and other is called your Mach frequency, that represent zero or that represent one. And here we show your envelope detector. Envelope detector, basically here we use a one diode which can which can help to extract the carrier from your modulated space frequency and modulated Mach frequency. So the carrier by the use of this block, इस ब्लॉक के थ्रू हम कैरियर को आपकी स्पेस और मार्क फ्रीक्वेंसी से क्या कर लेंगे, अलग कर लेंगे. जब हम अलग करेंगे तो आपकी इनपुट प्रेजेंट रह जाएगी, वन इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ जीरो एंड वन इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वन. इफ दैट इनपुट आर नॉट इन प्रॉपर वे, सो दैट विल बी रेक्टिफाई विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन कंपैरेटर एंड यू आर कैन गेटिंग द फाइनल आउटपुट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिजिटल. सो हेयर वी रिकवर यूर इनपुट डिजिटल डाटा एज इन प्योर वे. अदर so the envelope so here we also mention that the FSK input signal is simultaneously applied to the input of both band pass filter through a power splitter. The respective filter passes only the mark and space frequency on its respective envelope detectors. The envelope detectors in turns indicate the total power in each pass band and the comparator respond to the largest of the two powers. This type of FSK detection is referred to as a non-coherent FSK detector. And another figure which you can show in my slides, that is coherent detection. So in both of the figure there is a one major difference. Here we use the envelope detector to demodulate the carrier, but here we use a multiplier to demodulate the carrier. So here we can say that the power splitter also separate your space and Mach frequency that should be multiplied with a carrier, and the low pulse filter help to extract the carrier from your final space and final Mach frequency. So here we getting only the input data. If the input data is not as per the level, so that data will be converted with the help of your comparator circuit, which help to make the data in your digital form. So these two of the modulator are very important for you as per the exam point of view also. So in some cases we say that the coherent and non-coherent detection. In coherent detection, both carrier which we can use at the receiver and transmitter side are synchronized with each other. But in case of your non-coherent FSK receiver, both carrier which we can use at the transmitter and receiver side are not synchronized with each other. So that is a main major difference between your coherent and non-coherent detection. Next come with your phase shift keying. The phase of the output signal gets shifted depending upon the input. So the two types of, namely BPSK and QPSK, according to the number of phases shift. Clear? The other end is DPSK, which changes the phase according to previous value. So according to phase changes, we can describe the BPSK and QPSK. The QPSK cover in my later part of the video. So the phase shift keying is a digital modulation technique in which phase of the carrier signal is changed by varying the sine or cosine input at the particular time. And the PSK is a technique which we can mainly use in your wireless LAN, biometric and contactless operation along with RFID and Bluetooth communication. So here we represent a proper diagram for your PSK modulation. So that is your input data, which is in the form of 1 and 0. And that is a resultant pattern, which are getting after PSK in modulated form. So here we see that there is a phasor difference where the waveform changes from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. So when the wave changes from 1 to 0, the phase is reversed by 180 on this side. And either on this side when the wave changes from 0 to 1 or either for 1 to 0. So the PSK, आप PSK को ये बोल सकते हैं कि जब आपने इनपुट दी और आपकी इनपुट 1 से 0 पे चेंज हो रही है तो आपको रिजल्टेंट यहाँ से मिलना चाहिए था, लेकिन उसमें क्या आ गया, एक फेज डिफरेंस आ गया 180 का. और जब आपकी इनपुट जो है वो 0 से 1 पे जा रही है तो ये आपकी वेवफॉर्म नीचे को जानी चाहिए थी जो कि ऊपर से स्टार्ट हो रही है. सो देयर इज आल्सो अ वन मोर डिफरेंस दैट इज 180. सो 180 एंड 180 आर एड विच ईच अदर्स एंड अगेन यू कैन गेटिंग द जीरो डिफरेंस हियर. यू कैन से 360 अगेन हेयर 180 एंड अगेन हेयर 360. सो बाय द यूज ऑफ योर फेस शिफ्टिंग यू आर गेटिंग आर टू फेस रिवर्सल सच एज 0 and 180. We also show one more diagram. PSK and BPSK both are the same thing. So here we use the input data and you are getting the final result in the form of PSK with the multitude output. So here the waveform input changes from 1 to 0. The phase is 180 and the when input changes from your 0 to 1, the phase is also a 180. You can say 0 degree and so on. So we can say that in your BPSK, when the input changes from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1, your output will be changed as per the phases, either 180 or either 0. So this video, I can review my slides one by one. So today in my lecture, we are cover the various topic, which are, we can say that your ASK modulation, FSK, PSK and BPSK modulation. So the digital modulation having various advantage over your analog modulation, which we tell about my these slides, having more information capacity, high data security, quicker system and high with great quality of communication. And you can describe here where various type of communication, either ASK, FSK, PSK and QAM. And the other thing is called here amplitude shifting, where the signal is present, the carrier is present here. Where the signal is not present, the carrier is not present. And with mathematical expression, you can getting your final output in case of your modulated wave. And here we show your ASK modulator diagram. You can say transmitter diagram. So in ASK modulator, you require one input signal in the form of digital data, and the other is carrier, which are high frequencies wave. And you are getting the ASK with modulated waveform. Other one is called your frequency shift keying, and also show one diagram for your FSK here. So in which the frequency will be vary by two wave plus del f and minus del f, and the plus del f is called your Mach frequency and your minus del f is called your space frequency. So the Mach frequency represent logic 1 and the space frequency represent logic 0. So here we cover your coherent and non-coherent detection. In coherent and non-coherent detection, there is a one major difference between your coherent and non-coherent detection. In non-coherent detection, your carrier will be synchronized with your transmitter, and but in non-coherent detection, the carrier which we can use at the receiver side are not synchronized with your transmitter. Frequency shift keying having show here a difference of 180 from 1 to 0 0 to 1. So here we see here the 180 difference, and again 180, you can say 0 degree. So we can getting the output with the reversal property of your 0 and 180 degree phase difference. So today we are covering the lecture in exam point of view. We are covering various questions. That is, what do you mean by ASK, FSK and PSK modulation in 2 marks? And you also explain the ASK and FSK or PSK with full diagram and full mathematically analysis discussion. And also you cover the one topic, one is that is called your coherent and non-coherent detection in a fully way. What is the main difference between your coherent and non-coherent detection? Or you can say what do you mean by PSK, and how the PSK is differ from your ASK and FSK modulation. So these are the various questions which we can cover as per my today lecture. So thank you very much for seeing my video.